I don't know a woman that doesn't think about what they're gonna do every time they go get a mammogram. And I was always, part of my body I'm not really using. If it's trying to get me. Now, I did have a problem. They've been with me for 48 years. I'm used to looking at them. So there was a little bit of, well, they're gonna go away. So I was like, I'm gonna take a photograph.
Yeah, she said, I'm going in for a double mastectomy this coming Wednesday. And do you wanna document that? And I'm like, sure. And then she extrapolated and said, do you want to just document the whole thing, the whole process? And I thought about it for, a millisecond and said, you bet, I'll definitely document this whole thing.
Oh, there's, okay.
The beginning. With breasts. And then it continues on, going into the hospital. And at the time, you know, I didn't know what was going to come of all of the images that
we didn't even know what was going to happen with treatment. We had no idea what was going to go on.
It was just, I would meet her whenever, wherever I can to photograph and document. And
through treatment, she was probably the only person that showed up.
Consistently?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So in the photos, I'm happy every time she took pictures. But part of it is I'm happy somebody's there. I'm happy she's there.
The way that we helped get through all of this was through humor and just...
Sick humor.
Cracking. But it was funny. I mean, it really got us through just the intensity of... the treatments and everything and what she was actually going through.
We have Halloween where when you're bald, what do? You stick horns on your head.
Yeah.
And the nurses were not amused.
They weren't amused at all. And that would have been
There's something very wrong with them.
Yeah, see they really didn't appreciate that. But we thought it was hilarious. I believe that they all show the view, the whole process, and we really want the book to kind of educate people so that they know exactly what it's like to go through cancer treatment.
You know, being a cancer patient, you're a science project.
Yeah.
But what it feels like is being a prisoner of war inside yourself. I mean, when shit gets too heavy, you go have a beer. Can't do that. Yeah. There's no break. Mm.